Some books are lees frae end to end, and some great lees were never penned. Even ministers, they hae been kenned in holy rapture, arousing whid at times to vend, and nailed with scripture. But this that I am going to tell, which lately on a nicht befell, is just as true's the deals in hell or Dublin city, that ere he nearer comes ourselves a muckle pity. The clachan yell had made me canty. I wasn't a fool, but just had plenty. I stuck at whiles, but yet took tent aye to free the ditches, and hillocks, stains, and bushes kent aye frae ghaists and witches. The rising men began to glower the distant Cumnock hills out o'er. To count her horns wi' all my power I set mysel, but whether she had three or four I couldna tell. I was come roon about the hill and toddling doon on Willie's mill, setting my staff wi' all my skill to keep me sicker, though leeward whiles again my will I took a bicker. I there wi' something does forgather, that put me in a neary swither. A nova scythe out our ye shoother clear dangling hang. A three-tailed leaster on the other lay large and lang. Its stature seemed lang Scotch ale's twa. The queerest shape that e'er I saw, for faint a wame it had a vaw. And then its shanks, they were as thin, as sharp and sma' as cheeks o' branks. "Gideen," quo' I, "friend, hae ye been mawin' when other folk are busy sawin'?" It seemed to mak a kinna stand, but naethin spak. At length says I, "Friend, where are ye goin'? Will ye go back?" It spak recht how. "My name is Death, but been afflied," quoth I, "good faith, ye're maybe come to stop my breath, but tent me, Billy, I read ye weel, tak care o' skaith, see, there's a gully." "Good man," quo' he, "put up your whittle, I'm no design to try its mettle, but if I did I would be kittle to be mislaird, I wouldna mind it, no that spittle out o'er my beard." "Weel, weel," says I, "a bargain be it. Come, gie's your hand, and say we're greet. We'll ease our shanks and tak a seat. Come, gie's your news. This while ye hae been mony a gate at mony a house." "Aye, aye," quo' he, and shook his head. "It's e'en a long, long time indeed sin' I began to nick the thread and choke the breath. Folk maun dae something for their breed, and say maun death. 6,000 years are near han fled since I was to the butchin' bread, and mony a scheme in vain's been laid to stop or score me, till yon Hornbook's ta'en up the trade, and faith, he'll war me. Ye ken Jock Hornbook i' the clachan? Deil mak his kingshood in a splochan. He's grown sae weel acquaint wi' buchan and other chaps, the wains hood out their fingers lochan and poke ma hips. See, here's a scythe, and there's a dart. They hae pierced mony a gallant heart. But Dr. Hornbook wi' his art and cursed skill has made them baith no worth a fart. Damned hate they'll kill. 'Twas but yestreen, nae further gain, I threw a noble throw at ane. Wi' less I'm sure I've 100 slain, but deil my care, it just played dirl on the bane, but did nae mair. Hornbook was by wi' ready art, and had sae fortified the part that when I looked to my dart, it was sae blunt, faint hated would have pierced the heart o' a kailrunt. I drew my scythe in sic a fury, a near-hand cowpit wi' my hurry, but yet the bald apothecary withstood the shock, and might as weel he tried a quarry o' hard when rock. Even them he canna get attended, although their face he ne'er had kenned it, just shied in a kale blade and send it, as since he smelst, baith their disease and what will mend it at once he tellst. And then a doctor saws and whittles, or dimensions shapes and metals, or kinds of boxes, mugs and bottles, he's sure to hae. Their Latin names as fast he rattles as ABC. Calces of fossils, earths and trees, true sal marinum o' the seas, the farina of beans and peas he hast in plenty. Aqua fontis, what ye please, he can content ye. For by some new and common weapons, Uranus spiritus of capons, or mite horn shavings, filings, scrapings, distilled per se, sal alkali o' midge-tale clippings and money may. Ways me for Johnny Gedd's whole new, quoth I, if that they news be true. His braw calf ward, where gowans grew, say white and bonny, nae doot they'll rive it with the plue, they'll ruin Johnny. The creature grinned, an eldritch loch, and says, ye needna yoke the pluch. Kirkyards will soon be tilled and you tak ye nae fear. They'll a' be trenched with mony a shuch in 2-3 year. Where I killed yin, a fair stray death by loss of blood or want of breath, this nicht I'm free to tak my aith that Hornbook's skill has clad a score of their last claith by drap and pill. An honest wabster to his trade, whose wife's 2 knaves were scarce weel bred, got tuppence worth to mend her head when it was sair. The wife slayed canny to her bed, but ne'er spak mair. A country laird had ta'en the bats, or some kermurring in his guts. His only son for Hornbook sets, and pays him well. The lad, for 2 good gimmer pets, was laird himsel. A bonny lass, ye ken her name, some ill-brewn drink had hoved her wame. She trusts herself to hide the shame in Hornbook's care. Horn sent her after lang hame to hide it there. That's just a swatch o' Hornbook's way. Thus goes he on frae day to day. Thus does he poison, kill and slay, and's weel paid for't. Yet stops me o' my loaf o' prey wi' his damned dirt. But hark, I'll tell ye o' a plot, though dinna ye be speaking o't. I'll nail the self-conceited sot as deeds a heron. Neist time we meet, I'll wad a groat, he gets his fairin. But just as he began to tell, the old kirkhammer struck the bell, some wee short hour ayont the 12, which raised us baith. I took the way that pleased mysel, and sae did death.